So the Oxford Dictionary named climate emergency the word of the year in 2019, which seemed appropriate for a year marked by flooding and forest fires and hurricanes, not to mention emergencies of a more political nature as well. Reflecting at last year's end on all of these crises and the urgent advocacy that they spurred, it struck me that there is actually a certain appeal to the state of emergency. Regular life and its restraints are set aside, creating the opportunity for extraordinary action and rapid response. Lumbering bureaucracies mobilize to deliver swift relief. Neighbors act selflessly, even heroically, to help one another. And so it's tempting to wonder if we couldn't operate this way all the time, at least on the most exigent issues in our community. But the reason that the state of emergency works is because the competition for resources, the time, the money, the attention that characterize our democratic process are temporarily suspended. Decisions that we make to respond to a crisis are the opposite of the enduring and structural change that we seek. And so in preparing for 2020, I have been thinking about how we maintain the urgency and clarity of focus that accompanies an emergency while making the changes that we can sustain in the long run. This is certainly needed when it comes to addressing our local state of emergency last year, flooding that was historic by precedent, but will not be historic in terms of the storms to come. Stormwater infrastructure, and particularly the kind of large-scale projects that can remediate last century's suburban development practices, will be one of the major discussions and priorities of our capital improvement planning exercise this year. But they will be neither easy nor inexpensive. An urgency paired with sustained prioritization is equally needed when it comes to the cause of that flooding, climate change, and our community's response to it. I'm proud of the big, audacious goals that we adopted with the Community Energy Plan update in 2019. And in 2020, we are going to begin to make the hard decisions necessary for implementation. How will we transition our fleet to electric vehicles in a financially sustainable way? How can we help create the market conditions for advances in renewable energy generation and storage while reducing energy consumption in all of our municipal operations? On a regional scale, our Commonwealth ended 2019 on the precipice of a transformative passenger rail infrastructure investment. I am really looking forward to my VRE and Northern Virginia Transportation Commission roles in the year ahead to helping see it through and to dramatically cutting the transportation emissions of tens of thousands of Northern Virginians every day. When it comes to housing, since the 2015 adoption of the Affordable Housing Master Plan, we have been tackling our community's deep need for committed affordable rental housing with an energy and dedication befitting the emergency that it is. That is an urgency we must maintain. Yet we have been painfully slow to address the evolution of many of our low-density neighborhoods into expensive enclaves, out of reach for all but the wealthiest of home buyers. We have been too slow to confront the role that our own zoning ordinance plays in keeping our housing stock homogenous and unaffordable in too many corners of the county. This may actually be my fourth year in a row calling for the legalization of the missing middle of moderate density ownership housing forms in Arlington. But with our study kickoff set for this spring, I'm encouraged that action will at last be upon us in 2020. And lastly, I am excited that 2020 will finally be the year when we apply the same urgent clarity of focus that we bring to short-term school construction projects to the long-term, as in really long-term, facilities planning for the next 30 years and beyond. As our Joint Facilities Advisory Commission helps us draft that long-range public facilities plan, our planning staff have been working on an assessment of available county-owned land, identifying more than 24 locations already in our inventory that could be appropriate for school sites. My enthusiasm about this 2020 planning work is personal, as the parent of APS class of 2037. Yeah, that makes us all feel old, right? But also because it is a genuinely exciting opportunity to recognize that Arlington does have room to grow and that we're constrained less by our 26 square miles than we are by our own imaginations. After a 2019 of emergencies, it's probably too much to hope that the 2020 word of the year will be climate action or action of any form. But action can be a word to characterize our year here ahead in Arlington County. From our schools to our housing to our infrastructure, this will be a year to step up with urgency and with commitment. Thank you.